Hi everybody, it's Tuesday, and I'm gonna make a little vlog for you real fast. It's been a very good day for me, so I wanted to share. This is the first Tuesday in a long time where things have gone the right way. So, let's see where I left you guys. Last night, I went to bed. I woke up this morning really tired. When I sleep too much, that's what happens. I feel really exhausted the next day. I took a few laxatives last night because I haven't pooed in forever, and I needed to get the ball rolling. I didn't want to take a lot of laxatives because I had to work today for almost 10 hours. So I just took a few just to kind of loosen things up in there and, get things rolling. So, the things kicked in a little bit early this morning, and then kind of slowed down the rest of the day. So I was able to have just a nice, normal, smooth bowel movement, which was just what I needed. I felt really bad. I had like all this pressure and cramps in my stomach, and like it was time. I was just too full of shit. So I did poop in the potty. So I got dressed. I had to go to work. And I was running late because I got dressed at like the last second. I was very nervous going to work because it was another long day, and working with a new pharmacist and working in general. I don't know, I just felt really tired and exhausted, and the laxatives had me really drained as well. So, but I get to work, and Big Boob's texting me. You know, she's worried about these tests that she has to do. She wasn't able to pass a few tests. These are tests, incidentally, I come to find out that she and I have different tests that are due. Like, she has a bunch of tests that she hasn't done yet. And those are things that I already did already, you know. I have, like, two more exams that I have to do, but I've passed one last night. And then the other two, I just couldn't do it anymore because they made my fucking brain melt. And I was just too tired. I couldn't function anymore. So, I did half of one today. I kind of stopped because it was just too boring. Oh my god, I can't. But there's no rush to do those. The one that I did last night was the one that was in dire need of passing, and I had to do it. It was a deadline. So, the other two I can slack off one more day, and then that's it. My grace period is over. So, she's texting me. She's like, oh, please help me if you can. I tell her, listen, you know, I'll help you if I can. And whatever, you know. So I get to work, and today I work with the new technician. I work with the new pharmacist, this lovely woman. We'll call her Gym Rat because she's absolutely infatuated with fitness. She does CrossFit and all these things. Oh my god, she's like really into fitness. And I work with this other technician there. She's a man, I want to say a man hater, except she doesn't hate men. She's a woman hater. She can't stand other girls, you know, so we'll just call her Caddy. And so I work with Caddy, and I work with the Gym Rat, and I work with the new technician who has yet to have a nickname. I have to feel him out in order to give him a nickname. So I immediately get there, and I'm a little bit early, so I punch in, and I meet the new tech. The new tech is, he's not that tall. He's kind of short. He's short for a man. Usually, I like my men's tall. So, he's pretty short. Maybe he's like 5'6", I want to say. But then I feel like I'm giving him too many inches if I say that. Let's say between 5'5", 5'6", perhaps. I don't know, he's bald. He shaves his head completely. So, I'm used to bald men. I get along with the bald technicians. There's this other technician that I haven't worked with in a while, but I absolutely adore him. He and I just have a laugh, and he's also bald. So, I get along with the baldies at work. Maybe because my boyfriend is bald himself, and I don't know, I just get along with him. But anyways, so whatever, I get to work immediately, start working. And it's nice. It's a nice environment. Things are really busy. The Gym Rat pharmacist is, she's good, like, at her job. She's very good. But she's not like my favorite pharmacist. Like, my favorite pharmacist really just, he gets things done. I noticed we had a lot of prescriptions. There were a lot of things that she was doing. And I to myself, was taking notes like, wow, you know, like if this other guy was here, this shit would have been done already. Not Stick in the Ass. If Stick in the Ass was there, things would have been way behind. We would have been like a week behind and shit, but. But maybe it was her first day, and maybe that is what it is. She was wearing like a little dress to work, and so was Caddy. Caddy was wearing a long skirt and things. Our dress attire, we're like officey attire, you know, we got to dress kind of proper and things. So there have been some techs that wear dresses. I've yet to venture to the dress realm. I would like to, though, don't get me wrong. It's just that it's so effing cold in the pharmacy. I can't imagine, like I need fabric. I don't need less fabric, you know, so I can't imagine. But I would like to try one day to do the skirt route. My problem with the skirt route is that I like skirts that are like mini skirts, so those things aren't encouraged in the pharmacy, so I don't know. I need to find like some kind of common denominator, but it's hard. It's a trial and error thing. We'll see what happens. Maybe I'll wear a skirt with stockings. I don't know. It's just I'm freezing all the time in the pharmacy, so I don't know about less clothes. But anyways, they were kind of dressy today, and so I was surprised by the new tech. I kept hearing all these things that he's such a, you know, great tech and all this bullshit. He knows less than I thought he did, you know. He's like a newbie. He knows more than Stinky, I'll give him that much. Like, Stinky's just, Stinky's just a fucking bobo. He doesn't know anything, and plus he smells. He's like a giant ogre just bumping into walls in the fucking pharmacy. This guy knows more than Stinky, I'll give him that much. He knows more than Big Boobs and some things. He likes to work, though. He's very friendly. Throughout the day, I noticed that he's very friendly. He's very happy. He makes very corny jokes that aren't really too funny, but you kind of laugh because you don't want to make him feel bad, so. I don't know. I don't want to give him a nickname yet, but from what I've gathered from him, he's kind of peppy. He's kind of happy. He drinks protein shakes, so it leads me to believe that maybe he works out a little bit. So we'll call him Happy for now. Until I can feel him out. This is just the first day, a couple hours I work with him. Until I really know him per se, like in a, if I work with him more, then I could give him a proper nickname. But for now, we'll call him Happy. So Happy was happy. Happy was happy. Happy was very respectful with me, and he turned to me for a lot of things that he didn't know. I was really busy at certain times, so I had to tell him, like, you know, I'll help you out in just a second. In which case, other techs were like, oh, like for instance, there was a thing that he didn't know, and then another tech, I think it was Chatterbox, she came later to work. Chatterbox was like, oh, you know, tell Lou to do it, and then whatever. And so, and it was kind of busy, and I was like, listen, Happy, I'll help you in just a second, okay? And then Happy was like, you know something, just, sure, I'll, whenever you get a chance, no problem. But also, you know, just teach me how to do it that way. You know, like, I know how to do it, and then later I won't have the situation where I'm bothering people and things. So I like that from Happy. Happy was not trying to be a nuisance, so his nickname will definitely not be nuisance so far. But, Happy was happy. Big Boobs got there. Big Boobs was so whiny today. It was like working with a fucking child. It was like I had my kid in the damn pharmacy. It was just, and not even, because my kid is an angel. This bitch was like, just like a just annoying toddler, you know, just like if she could have thrown herself on the floor and cried and be like, wham, kicking her feet up, like she would have done that in dramatic fashion. She was whining about these tests. Now, I did her the favor and I did one test for her because I already did that test before, so I kind of knew it was kind of easy test. And I did it and I got 100% and she was so happy. And so, you know, then she bust out with other tests. I'm like, listen, those tests I've done before, but honestly, with all sake, I can't remember what it is. I was busy. And so I couldn't really just stop what I was doing and do all her tests for her. Like, tampoco si, you know, like, don't, you know. So, you know, she took her break, and then on her break she tried to do her test. She was just whining the whole time. Now, there, let me tell you something good that happened in the meantime. Other than the fact that it was a perfect Tuesday because of the gym rat pharmacist, that everything out this woman's mouth was, great job, you did good, wow, this and the other. Like, everything was just positive reinforcement. With her, I was telling my boyfriend, oh my god, it was just such a great day today. Like, if I, this woman was just, like, just purring to everybody. She was just telling everyone what a great job they were doing, how appreciated it was. I mean, if I was a dog and I had a tail, my tail would be wagging all of today, you know? So, I even got to have a break today. I don't usually get breaks with the other pharmacists, stick in the ass, it's never, and favorite pharmacist, hardly, few and far between that I get breaks. I actually got a break today. So, I ventured out of the pharmacy. On my way out of the pharmacy, I kid you not, I look down, and guess what I see on the floor? I see a bunch of money on the floor. Whoa, shit. I am with my phone, my keys, my wallet in my hand. I throw my keys on the floor immediately. I just grab the money, and I'm on my way out of the pharmacy. So I'm headed to Subway because I felt like, you know, I wanted to eat a little bit. So I ordered a little 6-inch turkey and cheese. And I have about half of that. And I sit in the Subway and I'm counting the money that I found. And I found $38. Can you believe that shit? It was a 20, a 10, a 5, and 3 single bills. Can you believe that? I found $38 today on my way out of work. So I felt good. Oh my god, what a great Tuesday. So see, that's why it helps to help people, because you get it in return. I remember, I think my boyfriend told me today or yesterday or something. He's like, what? You're helping Big Boobs with the test? And don't help her. Like, she's the competition. She's taking hours from you. And I told him, no, I'm not like that. Like, you know, you gotta help people. You can't just not help people. You're not gonna get blessings in return if you don't help others, you know? You may not get your blessings back the same way, but, you know, gotta look out for you. And look at that. Lord and behold, I, $38 just like that. So it's like I got paid to go on my break. So, whatever, I get back to work, and Big Boobs is still whining and complaining. Big Boobs and favorite pharmacist, apparently he is contributing to, I don't know if I mentioned this or not, but apparently Sweet Manager says that the schedule is out of his control, that he is not responsible for the cutting of the hours. He gets it from a higher power. The higher power is corporate, and it's also the pharmacist. Now, I was telling you that sticking the ass has something to do with that, but then favorite pharmacist does too. So, Sweet Manager is infatuated with Big Boobs, and, you know, Big Boobs is a little bit chatty and flirty and all these things, and she's always complimenting the favorite pharmacist and always flirting with him. And so, maybe, based on that, I don't want to believe solely it's that, but maybe he gets along with her better, so he's asking for her more on his shifts. So now, this last Sunday, she worked with favorite pharmacist, who coincidentally is on vacation this whole week. So I won't be seeing him at all if I get a regular, I'm hoping, schedule next week again if I get more days. And she was complaining about him, saying that she doesn't like him anymore because apparently he made her feel like dog shit on Sunday. He was calling her lazy and good for nothing and all these things, and she felt like she cried, and she felt like she wanted to punch out and go home. So this is what I'm thinking. I don't want to be mean or think bad things, God forgive me. Okay, now this could work out in my favor, because if he does have that side to him, if you piss him off and he is annoyed by you, he is not going to want you on his schedule. So maybe if she pisses him off enough, he will request less and less hours of her, and then yours truly can get more hours. So I'm hoping that she pisses him off royally, and then I'm back in like Flynn, okay? So I'm also hoping too that the gym rat, you know, she and I get along. There's more blondes in the pharmacy now. Caddy is a blonde. The gym rat is a blonde. I'm a blonde. So I'm hoping those blondes stick together. And I'm hoping that she too encourages me to have more hours in the pharmacy. So today overall was a great day. I found money. I got along with my new coworker. He didn't piss me off. And everything was great in the pharmacy. I only had one irate customer. And I would be mad too if I was him. This was a man who is mad because his penis is flaccid. His medication he was picking up was Cialis. And if you don't know what Cialis does, Cialis is like Viagra. It makes your penis hard so you're able to have sex with women and not go soft all the time. So, I've noticed this with customers that the majority of angry customers I get either get Propecia, which is to grow your hair, or they get Viagra, or they get Cialis, which makes your wiener hard. So if you're bald and your dick doesn't work, those are the most pissed off customers I usually get. So this guy, he came in the drive-thru, I got him. He picked up 5 pills of Cialis, which came out to almost like $40. And his insurance actually covered it. Insurances don't cover medications like that because those aren't needy medications. I mean, if your dick doesn't work and you're bald, that's not really necessary. What they're covering is depression medications, medications for schizophrenia, they're covering cholesterol, diabetes medication. Those are things insurances are covering. They're not covering this fucking vein medications. But I'm surprised his insurance actually paid for 5 pills to make his wiener hard. So, this is what happened. He comes, he gets his pills, and then he tells me that the doctor wrote out 30 pills of Cialis. He only got five. His insurance is actually paying for 5 pills a month until the 30 is filled. So this man is complaining because he wants 15 pills. He wants 10 more pills. And I'm trying to explain to him, listen, your insurance is not going to cover 10 more pills. If you want 10 more pills, you're going to have to pay out of pocket. So he's like, well, I want 30 pills. I'm like, well, if you want 30 pills, that's $998. Oh my God. Yes. You want 10 more pills? Okay, that is $400. So he's like, no, but the insurance, I said, listen, your insurance is not going to pay for this. Do you want the 10 pills or not? If you do, you have to pay out of pocket. So he got pissed off. He's like, yeah, let me get the 10 pills. So I'm like, listen, I'll give you the 10 pills, but you can't wait in the drive-thru because you're not supposed to. If you want, you could drive back around. It'll take me about 10 minutes to fill your prescription. Or you could come park the car, come inside the store. I'll be more than happy to assist you. He drove off pissed off. He didn't want to wait. Later on, I was like, oh my God. I told Big Boobs, I'm like, listen, you cannot believe this asshole that I got. But of course, you know, you will always get these assholes. The ones that are bald and their dicks don't work, those are the most angry ones. So it's without surprise. I was kind of hoping that it was almost time for me to get off. I got off at 8 o'clock today. I went to work at 12:30, so I was kind of hoping that I would be like off the clock by the time he comes back, because he didn't come back. I'm sorry, he didn't come back at the 10-minute frame that I gave him. So it's almost time for me to go, and he comes in the drive-thru, and Big Boobs gets him, and he just explodes on Big Boobs. He saw it was a different person attending him, so he was trying to be slick again, trying to get the 10 pills for like less money and all this shit. So he blew up on her. Thank God I didn't get him. So he actually paid like $400 for 10 more pills. That's crazy. My goodness. But anyway, so a good day overall. So yeah, so now I'm just gonna finish my wine, try to write a little bit and just relax. I hope you guys are all well. I miss you all. To Paradox, oh my God, I hope your kitty, I hope you find your cat. I read your post. I'm so sorry that your cat is missing in action. I hope she comes home soon. I hope, you know, things are okay. God, I would just be devastated if I come home and one of my cats isn't here or something happened to them. Oh my God. So I'm hoping that kitty comes home for you. To everybody else, I'm okay, hanging in there. I had a little bit of a sandwich today, that's about it. And that's all. I'm not gonna have any more. The rest of the sandwich, I put it away in the refrigerator, maybe I'll have it tomorrow. So yeah. So that's it, I'm gonna go. And we'll talk again tomorrow. So good night, goodbye, and happy Tuesday. Bye.